This first week, we are focused on a scripture from Exodus 31. Let me read to you from the children's Bible that I have. The Lord spoke to Moses, "See, I have called by name Bezalel, son of Uri, son of Hur, of the tribe of Judah. And I have filled him with divine spirit, with ability, intelligence, and knowledge of every kind of craft, to devise artistic design, to work in gold, silver, and bronze, in cutting stones for setting and in carving wood, and in every kind of craft. Moreover, I have appointed with him Oholiab, son of Ahismach, the tribe of Dan. And I have given skill to all the skillful, so that they may make all that I have commanded you, the tent of the meeting and the ark of the covenant and the mercy seat that is on it, and all the furnishings of the tent." The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Now I have here an iPhone. I imagine many of you have seen these and maybe even have used one. The iPhone, whether you're a fan of it or not, completely changed the way people use a telephone. When Apple decided to create the iPhone, they wanted to make it simple, easy to use, and above all, a work of art. The art of the iPhone was the work of a man named Jonathan Ive. Jonathan Ive is not an engineer or a computer expert. He is an artist. And if you don't believe me, you can go to the Museum of Modern Art in New York City to see some of the amazing designs he has created for Apple. Apple didn't have to make the iPhone, the iPad, or any of its Mac computers beautiful, but the co-founder of Apple, Steve Jobs, insisted on making them that way. Before Jobs hired Jonathan Ive, computers were bulky and boxy. They were functional, but they weren't very attractive. Steve Jobs changed all that, and Jonathan Ive was the man he chose to make that happen. Artistic creativity is a gift from God. In that passage we just read from Exodus, we see just how much God values this gift. God had just given Moses the Ten Commandments and was giving instructions for building the tabernacle, which was a traveling temple that would serve as the seat of worship for the Israelites as they traveled to the Promised Land. God had very specific instructions for the design of the temple, and God chose by name the men who would do the work, Bezalel and Oholiab. God told Moses he had given both men wisdom, skill, and knowledge to make artistic designs using gold, silver, wood, and other materials. God gave them these skills for a specific purpose, the purpose of making the tabernacle. God didn't have to make the tabernacle beautiful. God wanted it to be beautiful. God wanted the Israelites to see the beauty in the tabernacle and be reminded of their creator, a God who values not only creativity, but also the beauty that results from it. God has given each and every one of you a gift. Some are artists, some are musicians. Others may be gifted as speakers or teachers. Whatever gift you have been given, God has a plan for you. And no gift is insignificant. Whatever you do with your gift, do it as if you are working for the Lord. Always remember that it is God who gave you your gifts, and don't be afraid to let others know that God was your inspiration. I hope you enjoyed today's message, and I look forward to the next time I see you again.